In this section of Blogging 101, it's basically an introduction to some of the nuts and bolts of blogging, and we'll take a quick peek into the back office of Trade Show Guy Blog. And this is, of course, for WordPress only. That's the only blogging platform I used. It's highly recommended. And while there are others that are good out there, and we'll take a quick look at them before we get there, I recommend WordPress. I've had most experience with it, so that's what we'll be concentrating on here. There are other types of platforms, though. For instance, Blogger.com is something you might consider. It's free. It's owned by Google. So certainly anything you put on there would be search engine friendly. Of course, other blog platforms are. It's not exclusive to being search engine friendly. The pluses of Blogger, as I see it, are that, first of all, it's easy to use, easy to set up. You have four or five choices of themes, maybe a few more now. I've had a Blogger platform blog, the first blog I had, which was, you know, four or five, 6 years ago. But that is the upside of it. The downside of it is that, first of all, it's not your URL, so you don't own the URL. I believe it's yourcompany.blogspot.com. And you don't have as much control over the way it looks, and you have very little access to any sorts of plugins and those types of things to it. So it's a very limited sort of light blogger platform, if you will. Not bad for some applications. I think one of the downsides for business is that if you put a business blog with a blogspot.com URL in there, you're seen as someone who can't even afford a $10 per year personal domain and uploading the free WordPress or other blogging platform software. So blogger.com is really not something I'd recommend for business blogging. TypePad is one of those blog platforms which you do have to pay for. It's a premium platform. It's not very expensive, you know, on the order of 5, 10, 20 bucks a month, depending on what you get. I think there's some variations there. Of course, it's been a long time since I've been on TypePad. Maybe it's not the way it used to be. Maybe TypePad is different now. I do know that it certainly has some issues. There are not a lot of ways you can design it. Again, that's the same with Blogger. You don't have much control over the design and the look and feel of it. You have to pretty much use what they offer you. So again, you have a URL which is not your own URL. It's not something that you actually own. You can't upload this onto your own website and use TypePad. You got to use their platform. For some people, it's the right thing to do. As a business blogger, I would probably recommend you don't use TypePad. But again, for some types of situations, it might be something to consider. WordPress.com is different from uploading free WordPress software from WordPress.org. WordPress.com offers free hosted blogs using their software. Again, it's free, but the downside of this is your website is on their server. It is not something you own. You don't have nearly as much flexibility with it as you would with another platform that you own. For instance, I think they're limited on various plugins and widgets that you can install. Certainly you have more flexibility, I think, than Blogger and probably more than TypePad. But again, for a business application, I would not look at WordPress.com and using a hosted blog over there. Self-hosted WordPress is probably the most flexible, and it's certainly convenient. It's easy to use. There's a lot of flexibility to it. You have all the bells and whistles, and you own it. You own the software because you can upgrade it anytime you want. The software is free. You own the URL. You own the domain. So if it's yourcompanyblog.com, you own that. You control it. You are in charge if you have a self-hosted WordPress blog. Other options out there include companies and platforms such as Joomla, Squarespace, Drupal, Ruby on Rails, and those are the ones that you can certainly go out and do some research on. I don't have much information for them on there. I would say they're probably the lesser known, and depending on your goals and your technical capabilities within your company, those may or may not be the types of platforms that you want to look at when it comes to the nuts and bolts of blogging. So let's take a look at the Trade Show Guy Blog WordPress back office. Very quickly, let's go over here and see what we have. First off, you're going to see that I've got all of the, on the left here, you'll see all of the main headers. This is the navigation area, and we'll just take a quick look at that. Posts, you can go in and add new posts. Take all the posts, take a look at all of them, look at the categories, the tags, the calendar, it's all right there. Under media, you have access to what's in the library. You can add new media, I've got a plugin, which is the Showtime Slideshow, which is also part of the media if you want it there. Links, and this takes a look at any of the links that you have on your blog roll. You can add them, rearrange them, put them in categories if you'd like. The pages are different from posts. A post is going to go at the top of your main page, your front page. A separate page will be something that you have like an About Us or a contact page or your newsletter page. And so people will link that to that through their your navigation buttons at the top, and that page will be separate and standalone and unique from your front page, but it will look the same because it's got the same sidebars on it, although you certainly have flexibility to change that as well. You have a comment section. You can go look at all the comments in there, and there's various ways you can do that. I'll take a quick look at some of the comments here, some that are that just recently come up. There are spam catchers here, so you can catch all types of spam there, and you can approve these or disapprove them or reply to them. A lot of different ways you can get involved in comments. Your appearance, you have a lot of flexibility with your appearance. A theme is your overall look. A widget is something you plug in that allows you to do something. You have certain menus you can control. This is a plugin that I use, which gives me people gives me access to a tool that allows people to interact with my website in different ways. Vigilance is the name of the theme that I use, and this is a look at some of the options for that. And then there's the theme editor. If you want to actually get into editing the PHP code within your theme, this is the way to do that. I'll take a quick look here so you can see what we're looking at here. Versus, you have style sheets, sidebars, templates, all sorts of things right there. And if you take a look at the all of the various pages, you can actually go in and edit the actual the coding in here. So unless you know what you're doing and you can code these things and get in and out of there without messing things up, I wouldn't mess with them because there's a lot of code in there that unless you know what you're doing with the PHP coding, it's probably not worth messing around with. But you do have access to all that. So if you want to make specific changes within your template, you have the ability to do that. Plugins are things that you can use within your page that allow you to do things. For instance, one of the things I have is a plugin for podcasting. The podcast, when you upload media files, like an MP3 file, it will generate the RSS feed, and that is a plugin. So plugins give you a lot more capability. You can edit those as well, and you know, various things that I use in my website are all under plugins and widgets. You can have different users to your page. Add users. Take a look at all ones. You can edit them. You can edit your profile. Various tools in the navigation field give you a lot of look at the available tools. Import new tools. Change title tags. These are some of the plugins that I use as well. But you can get under the hood of this quite a bit. Settings. There's a lot of general settings. You can change some of the writing settings. Reading. They're just on and on and on. There's a lot of bells and whistles to WordPress as a blogging platform. I've got things to do with Google Analytics. I've got things to do with RSS feed burner, search engine optimization, title tags. There's other things in there which are very easy to use to get more readers, to interact with them better. A lot of different settings, and they're all under this particular heading right here. Other headings which may or may not come up on depending on how many different plugins and themes you have. Contact pages, Platinum SEO, which is a plugin. Tweet Meme was also a plugin. PodPress is a podcasting plugin I use. And again, these are all a look at some of the various things that you can do from your dashboard in the back office of your blog. And very, very exciting. When I first got into blogging, I thought, oh, geez, you can do all this. There's lots and lots of things here that I can learn. Now, if you like to get in there and start to play around with things and add things on, it's really hard to damage things too much because, generally speaking, you can undo things. Now, if you start to edit the actual code, you know, you're asking for trouble unless you know what you're doing. Ask someone that knows what they're doing. But you can get in and change things around, try how things look, change things. It's an immediate change. If you want to change the order of things in your right sidebar, for instance, change the header, change the banner, change all sorts of things, you look at them and then you can judge on whether that's something you want to do or not. So that's a quick look at the back office of the setup that I've got currently at Trade Show Guy Blog using WordPress free blogging software.